Hi and welcome. One thing I absolutely loved about playing Morrowind back in the day were the books. So let's recreate them with TextMesh Pro. And don't worry, you don't need to chop up your book contents in multiple parts to display on the correct page. We will have TMP handle it for us. This is how my scene is set up. I have some background art, an image of my book, and a component that handles the book setup and contents. I have a left and right page, obviously, which consists of the text area of the body text, a different text area for pagination, and a transparent image overlaid on top of it to return to the previous page or continued on to the next. I'll get to the event trigger in a moment. Let's start on the left side. I have prepared a lengthy story for this tutorial and will just drop it into the text box in one big chunk. Naturally, it overflows massively. To fix it, set the overflow method down here to page. Your text will now only be shown as long as the text box permits. Change the number of the page to see how the next page looks like. To prototype, add the same text to your right page as well, but set the pagination to 2. And keep in mind that pages usually start with 1 and not with 0. This is going to be how our book system will work. Have two text boxes with the same content, but displaying different pages. Let's write some code. We need a big enough text area for our string to be displayed in a way we can work with. Two TMP texts for the page contents, and two more for the pagination numbers. The space attribute creates a bit of empty space, so it doesn't look all too clumped in the inspector. Let's start with the method to fill our pages with the text we supplied above. Our method to display and update the correct page numbers isn't much more complex, since our text boxes already come with the page to display built in. To have our contents show up in the inspector, we will add an onValidate function and fill everything with the needed infos in case it hasn't already been done. Awake looks practically the same, just that we can skip the check. To be able to jump to the previous and next pages, we will create two methods. In previous, if our page to display is less than 1, we will set our page instead to 1 and return out of the method. After this, we will check if our current page to display minus 2 is still larger than 1, in which case we subtract 2 from the left side's textbooks page. Otherwise, we will set the value to 1. Our right side's page will always be the page after the left one. And lastly, we will update the pagination. Next page works like this. If we are already on the last page, we won't have to do anything. If our left side is bigger or equal than the needed page count minus 1, we will set it to that number. This way we can add one more page to the right of it without things going wonky. If we are not yet at the value, we increase 2 on the left and 1 more for the right side accordingly. And lastly, we update the pagination again. To call our methods, we will set them up via the previous and next page overlays, the ones with transparent images. They are as big as a page, so users can click wherever they want and they are raycast targets, meaning if we click on them, something can be triggered. In this case, it's the point-to-click event. Link up the book content class sitting on the book game object and the correct method for each side. Let's give it a try. This being done, just add a few more details. Sometimes your text might be divided in a way that you don't want it to be, like this headline here. You can tell TMP that you want some content to start on a fresh page, which might be of use here. Inside your book contents, navigate to the offending line and add the page tag in front of it. You might want to have your text be justified, just like in magazines. And you might want to rethink that. Justified text is super hard to design in a way that is easy to read while still looking decent. If you have a look here or here, the gaps between words are super wide, which makes reading it not as easy as it should be. If it's just one or two gaps, sure, that's not a huge problem. But with larger texts, it can become one. Secondly, those rough edges we get from side-align text actually help us while reading by guiding the eye to the next line of the text. As in, you remember how the end of the line you read before looked, so you can check if you grabbed the correct next one. If you want to offer a way to modify the text size to your players, have a look at this recent video I made, where I show how that can be done by using styles instead of changing the values of the text boxes themselves. I have been working with styles in this tutorial for the display of text, and I highly recommend the workflow. And lastly, if you'd like stuff to unlock when books or text get read, I explain how to create an event system based on TMP's linked text in this tutorial. That one might be about how to react to text contents, but since it's built on events, you can modify it to your liking. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. If you did, please like the video and subscribe. I have a playlist of neat functionalities TMP offers you might not already know about. If you'd like to get a starting point for using styles, I recommend watching this next. Have a great week!